Welcome. In this video, we'll go over four powerful approaches to GPU accelerated compute in Runpod, each designed for specific workloads and use cases. Pods are virtual machines that you run through the Runpod service. They are fully fledged servers running Ubuntu Linux that you connect through VS Code, Jupyter Notebook, the terminal, or any other application you prefer to install. In most cases, they will have between 1 and 10 GPUs for use, although you can also spin up pods with just CPUs for development, to run servers, or for any other reason you might need an economical machine in the cloud without GPU acceleration. Pods can be thought of as a versatile machine in the cloud that you start and stop as you need to, as if you were turning a local machine on and off. Clusters are an extension of the pod architecture. The resources for a pod are limited to what can fit on a single machine, which, as I said before, means 8 to 10 GPUs max. Clusters are a specially configured architecture that acts as a container for two or more fully equipped pods, which ensures that they all reside in the same data center with high-speed local area interconnects. With clusters, you can instantly spin up a fleet of potentially hundreds of GPUs to run large-scale training or inference tasks that would be way out of scope for a single machine. Unlike a pod that has a full-fledged operating system, serverless endpoints have a predefined purpose and execute a specific task and return a result. An example of this would be an endpoint that is set up to accept a prompt for a large language model prompt. When a request is received, it starts up a worker, loads the LLM, processes a prompt, returns a response, and then shuts down afterwards. In this way, they can be thought of as similar to how a programming function is abstracted. Public endpoints are an extension of the serverless architecture in that they are endpoints that are defined and maintained by Runpod, intended to give immediate access to popular packages with a minimum of friction or setup on the user side. This allows a user to immediately send requests without having to set up or maintain an endpoint on their own. This also enables Runpod to provide serverless access for certain models or applications that may not be open source or open weights, where end users would not simply be able to create an endpoint on their own. To illustrate the differences, let's go over a specific AI modality, in this case, large language models, and demonstrate how it might be implemented over all four methods. For pods, if you want to experiment or develop an application that uses an LLM, you can spin up a pod that runs a server like vLLM that sets up an API server. This lets you easily send prompts and get a response back within a development environment where you have low-level, easy access to the hardware that you can simply shut down when you're done using it. Clusters enable you to use a model that would be out of scope of a single pod. For example, a 1 trillion parameter model requires over 2 terabytes of memory to run, which is beyond the capabilities of even the latest generation hardware in a single pod. A cluster lets you load the model across several pods, enabling access to the most demanding models available. Serverless allows you to set up an endpoint that fields requests from several different users or sources. The endpoint accepts a request, runs a prompt, returns a result, and shuts down. This means you only pay for the time that the hardware spends doing useful work. This is perfect for applications like chatbots to prevent users from being frustrated by slow response times, while preventing wasteful spending on GPU pods that are sitting idle. Public endpoints are useful if you want to use an already well-established and popular model that Runpod has set up access for. This saves you the cost and overhead of maintaining and configuring the endpoint, while keeping your costs in line by guaranteeing a fixed cost for each generation.